Right, good, because that's exactly what we're going to be talking about right now, is the Patat Festival, am I right?
Yes, that's correct.
And will you, Renee, I know that's very much your thing, so let's start with you. First of all, let's get the dates.
This year, it will be on 15, 16 and 17 June. It will also be the 19th year that the Patat Festival has been in Napier. And of course, every year we want it just to grow and get bigger and more exciting for everyone that comes through for that weekend. We do have a few new things on this year, planning an exciting food demonstrations that will go on throughout the morning. It starts on the Friday, the 15th. There's always a dance and dinner at the school hall. And last year we started with a art ramble because Napier is also known for all its artists and the fantastic work they're doing. So we will redo that again definitely this year. And then the Saturday morning, of course, we kick off full steam with the runners, the cyclists, all the stalls. Last year we had 98 stalls, which was amazing.
Yeah, I was there last year. It was fantastic. Fantastic. All up on the field, up by the school, was great. Sunetta, have you got a comment there?
Yes, I do. If anybody is interested in taking a stall, they can contact me at the tourism office on 028-424-2584. 028-424-2584. And the cost of a stall is 150 rand for a 3x3, section 50 rand each for the power.
50 rand for the power, which is, that's actually quite something to have that facility.
I would urge the locals actually to, when they do want to have a stall there, to contact us ASAP, because we have found in the past that we actually get a lot of enthusiasm from outside of the area, and then suddenly a week before, our locals wake up and decide, I also want to have a stall, and then sometimes we just get too full, or we actually cannot duplicate stalls. We cannot have, for instance, 5 coffee stalls.
Right. It's not a case of somebody who decides at the last minute is guaranteed of getting a place.
Absolutely. Well, the new will definitely be the food demonstration. Bigger and better is going to be the parade. The parade was the first year last year, and we are going to have a little demonstration stroke party in Napier 6 weeks before the festival, just to get all the locals there and to inspire them and to enthuse them with ideas for their scarecrows, which again we will have this year.
Is that going to happen again? Oh,
absolutely.
Great, yes. I think that needs to also get much bigger, but that is something that I think that has been started, and I think it's exciting, and certainly if that can be built on and made much bigger, it's going to be a massive feature of the festival.
We will try and get them excited about doing floats as well. And I want to put that point forward that it doesn't only have to be the businesses. Any single person living in Bredasdorp or the area or Napier, come and do a float and join the parade. It's so much fun. And especially for all the visitors who book their seats on the verandas of all the restaurants to actually see this happening. And of course the school is still involved, although it's changed its name. It's now the Gala School of Skills in Napier, not the Napier High School anymore. So we still have a big part of the festival up at the school, and then people coming down during the parade, so the businesses will get all their business from lunchtime onwards.
Alan, can I just add there as well, on that request, because it's a village festival or a community festival, if anybody's got any great ideas of new things that they would like to add or new things that they are planning, they can always let us know. There's a brand new website that theoverbook.com, Rob Harris, made for us. The address is www.napierpatatfest.wordpress.com. Let me just repeat that
please
again.
Please do, yes.
It's www.napierpatatfest.wordpress.com.
Right, I suggest people go and have a look at that one, and I think keep an eye on it, because I assume you're going to update, and as things change, as new features come along, as new events come along, you're going to be updating that regularly and keeping people informed what is actually, how you're progressing with the plans.
Yes, definitely. We'll be marketing it aggressively. We'll also be doing a lot of Facebook posts and sending out news, press releases, etc. into the village and wider to the media platform.
I know Alice and I have spoken a few times about the whole point being festivals, etc., is bringing people for nights.
Definitely, Alan. I think it's very important that people offer value-added service, if you want to put it like that. People can think about offering packages where a business accommodation establishment has got the accommodation, the transport to the half marathon the next morning, breakfast, maybe a meal or two included there. So you don't just sell the two nights, you sell the whole package so that people feel that they've got more value for their money. And I think that way the businesses will also be guaranteed business and exposure.
I think you've got a fantastic idea there. I like the idea. And I think a lot of businesses need to start working together and cooperating. Because, for example, if a person's here for one or two nights, they don't want to eat breakfast in the same place every morning. They may not want to eat lunch or supper in the same place. So what stops a couple of people getting together, cooperating and putting a package together as a group where you all benefit? You're volunteering, I see.
I am a coordinator, so yes, I've got the hot seat. If people have got any ideas or packages or things that they are planning, they can just email me or they can phone me at the tourism office. Just my email again, it's sanette@discovercapegallas.co.za. You can either comment via Facebook or on the website itself. So really there's many ways of communicating.
In the past, Dee Robinson from the Red Windmill Nursery has organized open gardens. She's always selected 3 to 4 very different and diverse gardens where people could go and wander around and speak to the owners with regards to their gardens. But this year she's got a new take on it. She is going to throw it open and ask people to enter. And she has got a theme of renovate, rebuild, recycle. That will be her theme. So there will be various aspects of the garden, not necessarily your whole garden. It can just be a tiny section, maybe where you do your composting or anything like that. But it's about recycling and staying green. So maybe you will have her on air later, maybe towards the Patat Festival, to really explain that. But just I'm just mentioning that now. New also will be, that's also a way of controlling how many people are coming to the festival, is they will be receiving a little goodie bag, so to speak, and there will be something in there that they will either hang around their neck or attach to their clothes, so sort of a little. So when you walk past people, you can immediately see they have entered the festival, they are in the swing of things, they've received their bag. There will obviously be a program inside there, and it's also an opportunity for the business to put information about their businesses into this bag. The other thing that we want to reach with this bag is where people could actually, they will fill in a little tiny little form, not a big one, just tick, 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 where they can vote for the best scarecrow that is new.
That's a good idea.
Yes, so we are actually, we'll be asking the public to do the voting. They will also be able to vote for the best garden, open garden. They will be voting for that as well. And then, of course, the photographic competition.
So you've got lots of competitions going as well and lots of participation, public participation, which I think is a very, very good idea. I like the sound of that. And your goodie bags, can businesses approach you if they've got things they'd like to add into them?
Yes, once again, Sanette is the coordinator of the Napier Patat Festival 2012, so they can contact her on her details.
Right, Sanette. So any businesses out there that have got items that they'd like to contribute and have added to the goodie bags, they're going to contact you yet again.
Yes, that's correct, Alan. I'd also like to add, one of the big events with the Patat Festival is the Napier Half Marathon. And I'd like to congratulate Tom and Ingela for once again organizing a fantastic half marathon last year. They won the Boland 4-star award for the half marathon, and I think that is a big achievement. It's not done lightly.
No, that's quite something to get an award like that. Congratulations to them.
If people would like to get involved in donating spot prizes, they can also contact me. There's also going to be a fun ride mountain bike race where people can get involved. That's Dave will be organizing that, Dave Spillhouse. So with all these things, there's opportunities for marketing and sponsorship and getting exposure out there. As I say, we'll be marketing the whole event aggressively, so logos and all of that will be posted.
Sanette, Renee, any last comments you need to make or any other things you'd like to tell me regarding the Patat Fest, first of all?
Well, we're very excited to have Rudy and Marna Rick from Recreative on board as well this year, involved in the Patat Festival. And they are going to be in charge of the main road, because we really, really want the visitors to sit up when they drive through Napier's main road. So they've got all sorts of ideas which we'll soon be implementing.
That sounds
and
fantastic.
If anyone has something they would like to contribute to, contact Rudy or Marna with regards to the main road. We really do want people, as they enter town, to understand that something is happening here. And we want to start with doing that quite a while before the festival.
So it's going to be a real build-up.
Yes.
Which is exciting. And the scarecrows, are they going to come out a bit earlier this time?
I hope so.
And is the traffic cop going to stay, or is he going to disappear again? did anybody find him? Last year, the speed trap guy, he vanished.
Yes, and the year before, 2010, we had a hitchhiker, and okay. He got a lift.
Okay. So what happened to the speed cop then?
I'm not sure.
I can tell you, I think a lot of guys hit brakes very hard.
Oh, yes. People were actually phoning their spouses and saying, if you come into Napier, this one's it.
I got very caught the first time, I can tell you that much, if that makes any difference. But it was quite fun, I have to tell you.
Yeah, I think in general, what I would like to say is to encourage the whole village to become excited and about the festival and to throw everything they have into it. It's a one-time event in the year.
And then with regards to the Patat Festival, if you have any ideas, if you just want to discuss or talk something through, or if something's bothering you, just give me a ring or email me and we can set up an appointment and we can see how we can take your idea forward.
Renee and Sunette, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, Alan. Thanks, listeners.
Best of luck and see you again soon.